All right, welcome to Sermon Based Small Groups. If you hear screaming at any point and things going on, there are little boys running with lightsabers, somebody's bound to get whacked. So if you hear screaming, pay no attention. Friends, welcome to week two of Rooted. We're dealing with the idea of who do you stand with? What do you stand for? When we talk about it in the church, we understand, especially out of Luke chapter 4, that when Jesus was tempted to worship Satan to get everything, all the good of this world, he said, worship the Lord your God and serve him only. Then, just a little further, just about 8 verses further than that, in the same chapter of Luke, Jesus goes to the synagogue as was his custom. When we talk about standing, we understand standing in the context of a weekly church service, a gathering of the greater body of Christ, and worshiping together really matters. It really matters. Psalm 1 says it this way, blessed is the man who doesn't walk in the way that sinners tread, or the wicked tread, who doesn't stand in the path of sinners or sit in the seat of mockers. What is that saying? That we can't be like the people who make sin a way of life. We don't stand in that path. We stand for something else. We stand together, locking arms every week. This matters. What we do on Sunday really matters. Worship matters. Gathering matters because it's a greater body of Christ coming together to declare the Lordship and the purposes of God in this life and in the life to come. Our purpose presently now, we stand together. And my question would be, what keeps you from standing, right? What keeps you from really grabbing on and standing and worshiping? We do it at football games, baseball games, hockey games. We stand and cheer for people. We do it at concerts. We sing with people. We can do it. The question is, why don't we? That's something we're wrestling with. Will you stand? Will you stand in the greater gathering of the church? Lift your voice, lift your prayers, and lift your worship, and be part of the great chorus of heaven. That's the high calling of what we're talking about today. So friends, as you engage in this conversation, I'm excited for you to see how you wrestle with this text. Have you ever walked over and stood with someone out of a show of solidarity or support for them? Question two. Describe the last time you felt like you were standing with sinners, meaning because of your surroundings or the company you were keeping, you were being influenced by those who don't live under the authority or counsel of God in Scripture. So we often think peer pressure, for question three, we often think peer pressure is something our kids face or for teens and kids like that, but it's real for adults as well. Or actually, let me ask it this way, is it real for adults? Is there peer pressure? How does standing with other believers on Monday or on Sunday morning or Monday night, how does that affect your faith? Question five, does worship ever make you mindful of God's authority? Question six, do you think it's true that the enemy, Satan, tries to keep people from gathering with other believers? All right, guys, your sermon-based small group, hopefully it went awesome. Hopefully you're having great discussions. I hope you are blessed by this community and able to grow in the Word of God and your connections with it. Yeah, after this week, I should probably say I look forward to seeing you in church on Sunday or Monday. Have a great week. Blessings on you.